Everybody, what's going on? It's Jose Hernandez, back at it again. All right, guys, so today's pool list, it doesn't have a whole lot, but, you know, not a lot of big titles from Marvel came out this week, the past few weeks. So I think I have about, like, 6, 7, maybe. But, yeah, let's get started right away. All right, guys, first up, we have here, this issue, it was something. It was very hyped up for a minute. It was being very hyped up by Marvel, and it is right here, Captain Marvel issue number 1, written by Kelly Thompson. So before this book was a really good Captain Marvel story called The Life of Captain Marvel. That was Marvel's first book coming from Captain Marvel in its new relaunch called Fresh Start. And it got very good reviews from what I hear. I haven't personally read it, but I'm looking forward to, and from the reviews I've read and heard of, it's really good. It's a really good book so far. It changed up Carol Danvers' origin a little bit. Carol Danvers is Captain Marvel. It changed up her origin a little bit. Back in the day, she never used to be half Kree. Like in the movies, they said she's half Kree, but in the comics, she never really was half Kree. The way that she got her powers was it was erased off of the original Captain Marvel to her, and she absorbed some of that, and then boom, you know, she got powers. Don't question it. It's comic books. And so they finally changed up her origin in the recent Life of Captain Marvel story, and where her mother was actually a half Kree. So therefore, Carol Danvers, Captain Marvel, is actually a half Kree. And so this book was being hyped up so much because the last book, Life of Captain Marvel, as I've stated at least 3 different times, was really good. And this one was written by Kelly Thompson, not the same writer from the Life of Captain Marvel. Kelly Thompson is a hit or miss. She's a straight hit or miss. She can either write really, really bad books, or she can write really, really good books. I heard Mr. and Mrs. X is actually not that bad, but this book was not that good at all. Now, I want to so badly like Captain Marvel. I really want to. Brian Reed's Ms. Marvel series really made me like Carol Danvers, but I want to like Captain Marvel. I really want to so bad. And if you don't know, Captain Marvel is one of the most hated characters in comics at the moment. Now, this book was not that good, as I've stated already. It's everything that's been wrong with Captain Marvel for the past few years into one comic book. It's everything that's wrong with Captain Marvel's character wrapped up into one comic book. It's just not good. I give us about a 5 out of 10. I'm actually kind of disappointed with this because I really want to like Captain Marvel. I really want to read Captain Marvel. I want to read a good Captain Marvel series, but yeah. Next up, ladies and gentlemen, we have Amazing Spider-Man issue number 13. Now, this series started off really bad. I didn't like it. It started off very weak. And then it picked up around like issue 6. I want to say around issue 6 or 7, it picked up. It was really good with the Black Cat storyline. It was really, really good. And then it started the next storyline, which was not good. And it once again became meh. This is the conclusion issue to the current Spider-Man story. And it's ending off with a meh. I don't like it. It had its moments. It had its moments. Like, basically what happened is Spider-Man and J. Jonah Jameson get captured by an unknown figure, and also Arcade. Arcade basically made this whole entire trap room where Spider-Man and J. Jonah Jameson were stuck in. And they basically replayed J. Jonah Jameson's life from his abusive father. I believe it was an abusive father, from his neglective parents, to how he went into journalism, to how he lost every single woman that he's ever loved, thanks to Spider-Man, and then they basically fight off against this robot version of the Big Man, which is a very classic Spider-Man villain, as well as another classic Spider-Man villain, Scorpion, except this is the real Scorpion, not a robot version. As I stated, it was not that great of a story. It had its moments. I really liked whenever they were going through J. Jonah Jameson's past and all that. That was great character development, but it's just, I don't know, guys. I'm gonna keep picking it up because of Spider-Man. I'm a huge Spider-Man fan, but Nick Spencer's, wow, he's doing some weird stuff, I'll tell you that right now. I think probably the best thing about this series, the only good thing about this series so far, is that he brought back together Mary Jane and Peter Parker as a couple again. Now, if you don't know, they've been on a hiatus for a very, 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 very long time, but now they're finally back together. And that's something that all Marvel fans, including myself, have been waiting for a very, very long time. This issue gets about like a 7 out of 10. A 7 out of 10. No, a 6 out of 10. It's going to get a 6 out of 10. Right here, guys, we have Avengers issue number 12. Now, this is a really good book, guys. I praise Jason Aaron on his recent work for Thor, as well as this Avengers book itself. Now Jason Aaron is a phenomenal writer. He truly is. And in the Avengers book, he's been setting up so many stories, and it's great. Jason Aaron is a great writer. He's been setting up, okay, so right now the main plot is the build-up. He's building up to his new story coming out in April, the big event, crossover event, titled War of the Realms. He's building up to that, but at the same time, he's got all these subplots going on. Over here, you got Namor and Atlantis trying to sit there and attack the United States, trying to attack the surface world. The Avengers are trying to stop that. But on top of that, Marvel's Russian Avengers, basically, they're called the Winter Guard. They're trying to take care of Namor and the Atlanteans. But the Avengers are like, hold up, no, we got this. You know, you guys stay out of our way. And so there's like a small rivalry going on between those two superhero teams. And on top of that, it's revealed that Phil Coulson has recruited the Squadron Supreme, which is Marvel's version of the Justice League, to take care of Namor the Atlanteans, and they've been doing that. And on top of that, the other subplot that's going on is right now he's building up to this vampire civil war type story, and it's great. It's a great concept. We don't know much about it. We just know that it's happening. And in the last book, they recruited Blade onto the team, and in this book, it's official. Blade is now here. He's now in Avengers Mountain, and they're now discussing what's going to be going on with this vampire civil war. And the last page, he literally says, we got some vampires to kill. But in this book, it doesn't focus on any of those things. Basically, it's an other subplot. Black Panther, he's been made like the secretary. He's been made the secretary of Avengers. And so he feels it's his duty to do his best. Obviously, you're the freaking secretary of the Avengers. And so what he's doing in this issue, he's gathering a group of Black Ops, a Black Ops Avengers team titled the Secret Avengers. And I'm not gonna lie, it's a very weird lineup. It's a very weird lineup that he's doing. But he's making this Secret Avengers team so they can basically do the smaller stuff. The smaller stuff that nobody, not even the main Avengers team, knows about. Only he does. And this concept was originally made by Ed Brubaker back in like 2011, maybe? I don't know. But the original Secret Avengers team was Captain America, Steve Rogers, Black Widow, Moon Knight, Valkyrie, Nova, Beast, and War Machine. That was the original Secret Avengers lineup. And now this new Secret Avengers lineup consists of Black Panther. I never pronounced her name right. It's like Okoye. She's from Black Panther. She's from the movie. She got brought into the comics because of how popular she got. Kazar, Gorilla Man, The Wasp, Odin, and a few other guys that I forgot the name of. Now, you're probably thinking the same thing I am. This is a really weird Secret Avengers lineup. It is. It's a very weird lineup, but it works. Jason Aaron makes it work. Why? Because it's freaking Jason Aaron. That's why. This book... Guys, I love the Avengers. I love what Jason Aaron is doing with the Avengers. I truly do. It's a fresh take on them. It's a great lineup. And all these plots, subplots with the main plot going on, I love it. I just love that type of stuff, guys. I really do. I have to give this book a 9 out of 10. It strictly focuses on the Secret Avengers, Black Panther recruiting those Secret Avengers, and going to do missions for him. Next up, we have another one of Marvel's many events going on at the moment. Right here, The Return of Wolverine, issue number 4. Wow, Jose, why do you sound so lackluster when you say that? Wow, other Jose, let me tell you. This book isn't... it's like, I've said it before in the past when I've reviewed this book. It's good, but it's just dragged on. It's been dragging on for too long. This has been going on since Marvel Legacy, guys. Marvel Legacy happened in 2017. We're in 2019, and Wolverine still hasn't officially made his comeback yet. And it's a weird story. It's a weird story, and it's just it's hard to kind of wrap your head around because they completely wasted away at two of his great villains, his son Dawkins, on top of that Omega Red. And it's revealed that this woman he's been helping out, this woman that he's trying to find, her son has betrayed him. She's actually part of this secret organization that's keeping him in check. And he even attacks the X-Men in the last issue. They make him attack the X-Men in the last issue. I guess he came back and he doesn't remember anything. But you see, that's really freaking weird, because in previous stuff, it's actually hinted that he remembers everybody. He's even looking around for Captain America at the end of one of his, at the end of one of Captain America's issues. So it completely contradicts everything. I just think right now this is becoming way dragged on too long. It needs to happen. Just bring him back already, dude. Like, really. I know he's coming back in X-Men issue number 11. But I don't think we need a whole entire miniseries for this. I don't. I don't know, man. It's just, it needs to end. Charles Soule is a good writer. He is. But it's just, this needs to end, dude. I'm going to keep reading it. There's one more issue left. This is a 5-issue miniseries. This is issue number 4, so there's one more left. I'm going to pick it up, obviously. But this one I have to give about a 7 out of 10. It's lost its hype now. We just want Wolverine back now, man. Next up, guys, we have Fantastic Four issue number 6. The new story going on is called Herald of Doom, and this is the first issue in that story arc. So basically, the Fantastic Four and Dr. Doom have all gone back to their old roots. And in the last issue, as I've stated, we watched Ben Grimm, the Thing, finally get married to his long lover, Alicia Masters. And at the end of that issue, it is revealed that Galactus himself, has come to the Earth. He has come to the Earth, but he's not only come to the Earth, he's come to Latveria. He is coming to devour the Earth once more, but this time he's starting off in Latveria. So basically in this issue, Dr. Doom is fighting Galactus. Yes, guys, Dr. Doom is fighting Galactus, and it is freaking amazing, guys. And now Dr. Doom, he has this herald. It was revealed in the wedding special, I think. I don't know. It was revealed that Dr. Doom had gotten... It was revealed in issue number 1. Dr. Doom has this new herald. I forgot her name, but he's got this new herald that now obeys him. She does what he asks her to do. And so the Fantastic Four hear about Galactus, and they come to Latveria, and Dr. Doom sends his herald to go fight the Fantastic Four while Dr. Doom fights Galactus. Guys, this is a great book. It really is. It is not resolved. It is a great freaking book. Guys, really, this is great. Dan Slott, wow, he's impressing me. I'm not a huge Dan Slott fan, you guys know this. But he's doing some good things with the Fantastic Four. He's gone out of his way to say multiple times that Fantastic Four is his all-time favorite series. And I believe him now, because this is some good stuff. This is some good shit. Like, I applaud Dan Slott right now. This is some good shit. Good job, man. I gotta give this like a 10 out of 10. It was great. And guys, right here, we have the current end of his story that's been going on for quite some time. 10 weeks to be precise. Uncanny X-Men issue number 9 and Uncanny X-Men issue number 10. Now, in issue number 8, we saw that Legion tried to fight X-Men himself. Now, Legion and X-Men are both Omega level mutants. They're both two of the most powerful telepaths in all of the Marvel Universe. The X-Men know that. So, oh, wow. The X-Men know that. So, the thing is, Legion probably is one of the only ones that can defeat X-Men. He really is. So Legion goes inside X-Men's mind, but the thing is, it backfires. X-Men's too powerful. X-Men has had time to develop his powers. X-Men has had time to practice his powers. Now he's the most powerful telepath, and he overpowers Legion. So basically, he takes over Legion's body, and they merge into one. Yes, that is right. X-Men and Legion merge into one person. And X-Men taking over the whole entire mind of that one individual. And so, two Omega level mutants, Legion and X-Men, now as one. That is freaking OP. So now it's Legion and X-Men, this combination, versus all of the X-Men. Every single X-Men, every single person that's been X-Men is now here except for Wolverine and Cyclops. Every single X-Men, anybody who's ever been an X-Men is now here in this fight against Legion and X-Men. It is a badass fight scene. And what's my favorite part about it is that it comes down to Jean Grey having to fight her own son, X-Men. Yes, if you didn't know, I think I may have stated it in the last video. I may not have. I'm not sure. But X-Men is the son of Jean Grey. That is a fact. And so Jean Grey is the most powerful telepath out of all the X-Men. So basically she goes inside of her son's mind and they have a small little telepath fight. And at the end of the issue, at the end of issue number 10, basically the X-Men, they defeat X-Men, but he pulls a Scarlet Witch. He pulls a Scarlet Witch, and it's revealed that he wipes out the mutants. But the thing is, we don't know if he's wiped out the mutants. We don't know if they just disappeared. We don't know if he's killed them. They're just gone. And so at the end of this issue, it is revealed that Cyclops has returned. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Scott Summers, Cyclops, he is back on the X-Men title. Cyclops is finally back. And guys, I am so hyped about that. Yes, guys, it is revealed that Cyclops is back. I think I said that two different times already, but I don't care. Cyclops is back. And it's a very exciting time to be an X-Men fan. It really is. It's a very exciting time to be a Marvel fan, as I've stated before in the past. And this issue and this story gets a 10 out of 10. Guys, this is a great book. It is. It is a great book. I wonder what's going to happen. I wonder how they're going to go from here. I know Matthew Rosenberg is the one taking up the mantle of the main writer for this series in the next few issues. And this week, I'm going to be picking up my pull list from the past 2 weeks, so I get to see how that's going to be played out, because Uncanny X-Men Annual Number 1 has been released, and so that has all the answers apparently, so I'm excited to pick that one up. I'm excited, guys. It's a great time to be a Marvel fan. It really is. And that is all I have for you guys today. Thank you for tuning into this episode of Marvel Pull List. Really, guys, it means a lot to me that people actually come to watch me talk about comic books. It's getting more views. It might not seem like a whole lot to you guys, but for me, it's like going from 3 views in one day to like 15 to 20 views in one day. It's pretty good. It is. It might not sound that good, but you know, small beginnings. That's all I have for you guys today. Thank you once again for tuning into this Marvel Pool List. Go look at my other ones. I love talking about comics. You'll obviously see that. I love talking about comics. I have music playing in the background all the time. And go look at my other work, guys, too. You know, I'm a young cinematographer. Go look at my other work. I have quite a few short films on there. My first low budget Layaki is officially out. You know, go to my playlist and go play out from episode 1 to episode 4. That's all of part 1. Part 2 will be coming out, hopefully after spring break, but we'll see. Yeah, guys, really, thank you so much to all my supporters. I really appreciate it. You have no idea. I know I do this probably after every single pull list. After I finish talking about my comics, I always talk about how grateful I am for you guys. And that's the truth. I am. I really am grateful for you guys. I really am. I'm grateful from my friends that lets me know their support, from the people I went to school with that I barely talked to that let me know their support, from complete strangers I don't even know that let me know their support. It's a great feeling, guys, and I'm excited on where I'm gonna be heading in the future. I really am. And you guys are gonna be there for the whole entire ride as well. So anyways, for the third time, that's all I have for you. Okay, tune in next week. I'm really going to try and get another pull list in next week, if not this weekend, this upcoming weekend. But right now, I'm going to edit this video while I'm watching Royal Rumble, because Royal Rumble is on tonight. I'm currently filming this on Sunday, and we'll see. Royal Rumble's on tonight. I'm so excited. Just in case you didn't know, I'm a huge professional wrestling fan, and Royal Rumble is on tonight. If you want to hear me talk about professional wrestling, let me know. Also, as well, I'm going to be doing a Q&A video very, very soon, talking about Layaki. So if you have any questions about the project Layaki, send them in. How did you make this, Jose? What's the relationship like between you and Chase, Jose? How did you get all these actors in it, Jose? Who choreographed all the fight scenes, Jose? Anything you guys got for me, really, just let me know. Ask me, even if it's just not about Layaki. If it's just a question you want to ask me, go ahead. I don't care. I will take up all questions for this Q&A. That's it, guys. Thank you for tuning in. Bye. Shit, bitch. Yeah, Shaq West said I'm getting really rich. See how I caught it, cause I'm really with the shit. See me in the streets and I be really with a bad bitch. Nigga straight rock. Nigga straight see me with